Rogue MP Craig Kelly has plunged the government into a fresh crisis tonight, sensationally quitting the Liberal Party to move to the crossbench. It leaves Prime Minister Scott Morrison with a precarious majority and overshadowed a move to permanently increase unemployment benefits.
When troubles come, they come in legions.
Well, with a very heavy heart, I've resigned as a member of the Liberal Party.
Sydney MP Craig Kelly has dramatically quit the government in a week when the Prime Minister is also battling disturbing allegations from four women that an ex-Liberal staffer is a serial sex offender. But Scott Morrison is striking a defiant tone.
I want to assure all Australians that I can tell you nothing will distract me or my government from my pledge to them to save lives and save livelihoods.
The latest distraction says he will not interfere with government money bills or vote to bring it down.
I'll of course support the government on matters of supply, confidence and procedure.
But the numbers on all other votes now couldn't be tighter.
Can the Prime Minister confirm that today the government has lost its majority on the floor of the House of Representatives?
The status of the parties in the House is as a matter of common knowledge.
The government now has 76 members in a lower house of 151 MPs, but one is the Speaker who only votes when the House is deadlocked. Craig Kelly lifts the crossbench numbers to seven, and if they vote with Labor's 68 MPs, the numbers are tied at 75 each.
I've been subject to a slander and smear campaign.
Craig Kelly was recently censured by the Prime Minister for undermining confidence in the vaccine rollout.
What do you say to your colleagues who say that you are selfish, you are self-centred, you are doing this only for you?
I'm doing this because I believe we can save lives.
The latest drama came on a day when the government moved to permanently increase the rate of unemployment benefits.
We need to ensure that we have a system that is fair and sustainable for the people who need it and the taxpayers who pay for it.
The JobSeeker base rate will rise by just over $50 a fortnight to $620.80. The parenting payment and youth allowance will get similar boosts.
This is the single biggest increase in unemployment benefits since 1986.
All benefits will fall by $150 a fortnight at the end of March when the emergency COVID supplements are withdrawn. So the permanent increase of $4 a day is being dismissed by some as an insult.
A heartless betrayal of the millions of people who have been hit by unemployment.
We're a great nation, but this is such a dumb thing to do, to treat the poorest of the poor this way.
The Prime Minister says his only focus is on getting the unemployed back to work, but he has a few other things on his mind. Chris Yorman, Nine News.
OK, let's go live to Canberra. Hand our political editor, Chris Yorman. Chris, there was a win for the government in its fight against Facebook.
Yes, Pete, Facebook has refriended Australia and will reboot local and international news feeds. They were shut off last week in a spat over the government's media bargaining laws designed to force the tech giants to pay for the news they run that's made by Australian companies because billions in local advertising dollars are being hoovered offshore. The Treasurer had six calls with Facebook founder Mark Zuckerberg over the last 2 days and hammered out an agreement to make a couple of minor amendments to the bill that don't change its intent. So Facebook will return to the negotiating table with local media companies, the government will claim a significant victory, and everyone will enjoy the kind of friendship you have on social media, Pete. Transactional, fleeting, and impersonal.
Chris, thank you.